Welcome back to all in the online session. Dear students, in today's online class, we would like to proceed our next chapter, and you know that its name is The Address. And this poignant story, sad story, miserable story is being written by Marga Minkow. Right? If we talk about Marga Minkow, she is Dutch writer as well as journalist. She was born on 31st March 1920. Okay? It was the basic information about the authoress. We can see say here authoress. Right? Before going in the deepest of the explanation, paragraph as well as episode of the story, we must know something about the basic theme around which scenario the story is being moved. We must know it. So I have mentioned here few lines. The story revolves around the theme of ये जो स्टोरी है द एड्रेस जिसको Marga Minkow ने नोट डाउन किया हुआ है ये स्टोरी पूरी मूव करती है कंप्लीट स्टोरी इज बीइंग सराउंडेड विद क्राइसिस दैट वी एज एन इंडिविजुअल इनकाउंटर इन आवर डेली लाइफ इट मीन्स क्राइसिस प्रॉब्लम sadness, miserable condition is being depicted, is being mentioned in the story, is being showed in the story. No doubt, as we an individual, we also face such conditions in our daily routine, in daily life. Okay? Next thing, no doubt, war brings destruction. Pain and loss of lives which impact humans in various ways. It means nisandeh, without any doubt we can say war brings destruction, destroy, ruined, and pain, sorrow, anguish एंड लॉस ऑफ लाइव्स युद्ध से लड़ाई से हमें क्या मिलते हैं डिस्ट्रक्शन बर्बादी होती है सारी चीज़ें नष्ट हो जाती हैं ध्वस्त हो जाती हैं पेन दुख मिलता है दर्द मिलता है एंड लॉस ऑफ लाइव्स जीवन खत्म हो जाता है जीवन खत्म होने का आशय इट मीन्स वी आर कंपल्ड टू फेस इलिट्रेशन अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट So many things are there which impact humans in various ways, जो मानव समाज को कई तरीके से प्रभावित करती है शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में चिकित्सा के क्षेत्र में स्वास्थ्य के क्षेत्र में रोजगार के क्षेत्र में इन तमाम प्रकार की चीज़ों के क्षेत्र में वार का इम्पैक्ट पड़ता है और मानव जीवन बहुत बुरी तरीके से प्रभावित होता है राइट लास्ट statement is mentioned here however this story speaks about the narrator's and her mother's life this story is being explained by the narrator and her mother's life connectivity attachment emotional attachment how they are disrupted due to war how their emotions how their attachment how their connectivity is being disrupted is being interrupted is being breakdown due to war all these scenario all these points have been explained in this poignant story I hope द थीम ऑफ द चैप्टर, द थीम ऑफ द स्टोरी हैज बीन क्लियर टू एवरीबडी. नाउ कम टू द पैराग्राफ नंबर 10, चैप्टर 2, पैराग्राफ 10. वेरी सॉरी, चैप्टर 2, पेज नंबर 10. ओके, यू आर बीइंग रिक्वेस्टेड टू पुट योर फिंगर ऑन प्रॉपर लाइन एंड लिसन व्हाट इज द एक्सप्लेनेशन, मीनिंग एज वेल एज सेंस. बिफोर पैराग्राफ देयर इज मेन पॉइंट इज गिवन इन द बॉक्स. आई एम गोइंग टू रीड दैट. दिस स्टोरी इज अ पॉइग्नेंट अकाउंट ऑफ अ डॉटर हु गोज इन सर्च ऑफ हर मदर्स बिलोंगिंग आफ्टर द वॉर इन हॉलैंड. राइट, दिस स्टोरी इज अ पॉइग्नेंट अकाउंट. पॉइग्नेंट, पी ओ आई जी एन ए एन टी, पॉइग्नेंट, इट मीन्स सैड, सैड, पेनफुल, इट मीन्स दुखांत, दुख से भरी हुई. ये जो कहानी है, अकाउंट ऑफ डॉटर हु गोज इन सर्च ऑफ हर मदर्स बिलोंगिंग आफ्टर द वॉर, इट मीन्स द प्रोटैगनिस्ट. प्रोटैगनिस्ट मीन्स मेन कैरेक्टर ऑफ द स्टोरी. इट मीन्स द नरेटर, इट मीन्स द डॉटर हु गोज इन सर्च ऑफ हर मदर्स बिलोंगिंग आफ्टर द वॉर इन हॉलैंड. When the war was being over in Holland, then after the narrator of the story decided to go to search out all the equipment, all the belongings, all the articles which was associated, connected to her mother. When she finds them, the objects evoke memories of her earlier life. When she finds them, it means after finding all the equipment, all the articles, suddenly earlier memories has been rising there. It means जो हाल ही की यादें थी वो तुरंत क्या हो जाती हैं, तरोताज़ा हो जाती हैं. सो दैट शी डिसाइड्स टू लीव देम ऑल बिहाइंड एंड रिसॉल्व टू मूव ऑन. कंसिक्वेंटली शी डिटरमाइंड टू लीव ऑल द इक्विपमेंट, टू लीव ऑल द आर्टिकल्स एज वेल एज ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड मूव फॉरवर्ड. टू मूव ऑन उन्होंने, इट मीन्स नरेटर ने यह डिसाइड किया कि इन सब सारी सामानों को मैं यहीं पर ड्रॉप कर दूंगी, छोड़ दूंगी और पीछे मुड़ करके नहीं देखूंगी, आगे बढ़ती हुई चली जाऊंगी. बिकॉज ऑल दैट आर्टिकल एज वेल एज इक्विपमेंट प्रोवाइड्स अ पेन, सैड, miserable, creates miserable condition. Now let's see statement. Do you still know me? I asked. The woman looked at me searchingly. She had opened the door a chink. I came closer and stood on the step. It means there is word chink. Chink, C-H-I-N-K, chink. It means narrow opening, हल्का सा open करना. दरवाजे को उसने थोड़ा सा open किया, right? Chink. I came closer and stood on the step. It means the protagonist asked the woman, asked to a lady, स्टैंडिंग एट द डोर स्टेप इफ सी स्टिल नो हर. इट मीन्स द नरेटर अराइव्ड एट द डोर स्टेप ऑफ अ वुमैन ऑफ अ लेडी एंड सी आस्क्ड इफ सी स्टिल नो हर. The woman looked at me searchingly. It means the lady, the woman looked towards the protagonist, towards the narrator, in questioningly, in doubtful mode. She had opened the door a chink. It means the lady, the woman had opened the door a little. She did not open the door wide. I came closer and stood on the step. It means the protagonist came closer to the door and stood there. When the door was opened a little, then, just then, the protagonist, the narrator, the speaker of the story, came closer to the door. Came closer to the woman. No, I don't know you. I am Mrs. Essa's daughter. It means the woman answered her. Her means narrator, protagonist, speaker of the story. No, I don't know you. It means the woman, the lady answered her negatively that she did not know to her. Then she replied, she answered, responded, I am Mrs. Essa's daughter. It means the woman responded. When the woman responded her negatively, then after narrator responded that I am the daughter of Mrs. Yes. Is it clear to all? Next thing, she held her hand on the door as though she wanted to prevent it opening any further. Her face gave absolutely no sign of recognition. She kept staring at me in silence. It means the narrator had held the door tightly, right? The narrator had hold the door tightly as she did not want to enter her in the house. It was being calculated in the mind of narrator. Her face gave absolutely no sign of recognition. It means there was no sign, there was no any trace or mark on the face of, on the forehead of lady that she is able to identify, she is able to recognize to the narrator, to the protagonist. She kept staring at me in silence. Continuously, the lady was gazing at me, continuously looking towards me. Perhaps I was mistaken. I thought perhaps it isn't her. Then the protagonist, the narrator, it means the speaker of the story, concluded in her sense, in her mind, that maybe I did a mistake. I arrived at unknown person's place. I had seen her only once, fleetingly, and that was years ago. It means I came across to her. Her means that lady, that woman, in short time, randomly, before years, many इनको जल्दी में कई वर्षों पूर्व देखा था। हमारी इनकी मुलाकात पिछले कई वर्षों पूर्व हुई थी, वो भी जल्दीबाजी में हुई थी। सो दैट इट मे बी दैट आई एम अनेबल टू रिकोगनाइज हर एंड सी इज अनेबल टू रिकोगनाइज मी ऑल्सो। इट वॉज मोस्ट प्रोबेबल दैट आई हैड रंग द रॉन्ग बेल। मे बी आई हैड टेस्ट आई हैड नॉक द रॉन्ग बेल। इट मीन्स आई अराइव्ड एट द रॉन्ग प्लेस। इट मे बी शी वॉज वियरिंग माई मदर्स ग्रीन निटेड कार्डिगन। द प्रोटागनिस्ट नोटिस्ड ऑब्जर्व्ड दैट द लेडी द वुमैन वॉज वियरिंग पुटिंग ऑन ग्रीन निटेड कार्डिगन। The wooden buttons were rather pale from washing. It means the buttons of the cardigan was being demolished. Its color was being faded as well as demolished because of being old. She saw that I was looking at the cardigan and half hid herself again behind the door. The woman felt that the protagonist is trying to look towards cardigan. Then she tried to hide herself behind the door. But I knew now that I was right. Just then, protagonist, narrator, speaker, determined, concluded in her mind that I am not wrong. I am at the right place. I arrived very appropriate place. It is the place where I can get all the equipments, all the articles belonging to my mother. Well, you knew my mother? I asked. It means once again, the narrator asked same question. It means a narrator asked a question about her mother, right? Well, you knew my mother? It means, do you know about my mother? Have you come back? Said the woman, I thought that no one had come back, only me. The woman asked her, did you come back here again? Did you not go up to now? I thought that no one had come back. It means there is no one with me here. I am standing here before some time. I did not come here again. Only me. It means there is no any person with me. A door opened and closed in the passage behind her. A musty smell emerged. Musty means stale. A door opened and closed in the passage behind her. It means it was the activity of opening the door. A musty smell emerged. There was a stale smell around all over. It means it was unbearable. I regret. I cannot do anything for you. After seeing the protagonist, the lady, the woman responded negatively. She avoided her and told she could not do anything for her. She was unable to do. She means the woman, the lady was unable to do anything for the protagonist. And the protagonist was very puzzled. She was in pain. She was trying a lot. She was making effort to collect all the equipment, all the articles belonging to her mother. But the lady was unable to understand her pain. Then, "I have come here especially on the train. I wanted to talk to you for a moment." The protagonist replied, put her views there, that she arrived there especially to talk to her. It means the protagonist arrived there to talk to that lady, but she was trying to ignore her. "I wanted to talk to you for a moment." It means the protagonist was very passionate, very desired, insisted to talk for a little moment. But the lady was not ready for that. "It is not convenient for me now," said the woman. The lady responded her that she is not comfortable right now. It means she was not comfortable right now to talk to the protagonist. I can't see you and the time. It means the woman responded she was unable to talk to her. "Come again." It means next time we would like to talk. I hope all of you understood all these paragraphs very well, including theme, basic information, a little information about the authoress, as well as text, right? Thank you for attending the class. Have a nice day.